Hi, my name is Sister Constance. I'm a little sister of the poor. I am here at John Jugon Residence in Washington, D.C., the United States, and we're about to begin a holy hour, a rosary-based holy hour that is being animated by Janice Clark, a consecrated virgin, and Father Peter Ryan, a Jesuit, who's from the United States Conference of Catholic Bishops. And we've invited our friends and benefactors here to join us, our elderly residents. And the reason for the Holy Hour is that today is the feast day of Saint Joseph, the patron of our congregation of Little Sisters. And we place a lot of confidence in Saint Joseph. And we're here praying for a favorable outcome to our lawsuit before the Supreme Court. This week will be on Wednesday, the 23rd of March, will be our argument before the Supreme Court. And so we're just storming heaven to pray for a favorable outcome to the case. The basis of our case is that the federal government is mandating that we change our health care plan to include services which are in violation of our Catholic faith. And we've gone through quite a few efforts to ask them, to plead with them to change their position on this and to give us an exemption from this mandate so that, you know, we will not be subject to it, but they have not granted us that. And so here we find ourselves with a case before the Supreme Court. And the thing is that one third of Americans do not have health plans that are subject to the mandate. So although the United States government is insisting that we have to provide these services because of a pressing public health need, at the same time, they have exempted 1 in 3 Americans from receiving health care insurance that includes them. And so we're just asking for the same exemption that some of major corporations have gained, and as well the health plan from the government for military families and the health benefits for the disabled do not include these services. So we're just asking for the same exemption so that our religious liberty will be respected, and basically so that we can go on doing what we've always done to care for the elderly. We are an international congregation, so we have homes in 31 countries around the world. Here in the United States, we have 27 homes for the elderly. And if we were not successful in our case, we would be subject to $70 million in fines per year here in the United States. So I think you can understand that that's pretty insurmountable amount. So we are here this afternoon. We're about ready to get started. Our holy hour is being broadcast by Shalom World TV. So I'd like to invite our worldwide audience to join us in our chapel and to pray to Mary, our Blessed Mother, and to Saint Joseph for a just resolution to our case this week in the Supreme Court. Thank you very much.
Please stand.
Earth, we are children.
Welcome, everyone. Please be seated. I'm Father Peter Ryan, Executive Director of the Bishop's Secretariat of Doctrine in the U.S. We're gathered here today to pray for religious liberty, especially for the Little Sisters of the Poor, whose case will soon be argued before the Supreme Court. Before I explain further, let me introduce to you Janice Clark, President of Word for Life Rosary Mission.
Thank you, Father. Good afternoon. It is such a privilege to be here, to stand in solidarity with the Little Sisters of the Poor, who I have known for many years, and have had the awesome privilege of serving as a volunteer in one of their homes. Their homes, when you step into their homes, you experience the kingdom of God in a very real and tangible way. You experience the mercy of God gushing forth through these sisters as they minister to the elderly residents. You experience the mercy of God gushing through these elderly residents who have so much to teach us about love and mercy. It is such a privilege, sisters, to be here standing in solidarity with you to pray for your upcoming court case, to pray with you for religious liberty, and to stand with you who have become a light. I mean, you were already and always have been a light, but the Lord is just making you shine brighter and brighter, and it's such a joy to be standing with you in this. Jesus is here. We are here to gaze with Mary on our Jesus. On our Jesus, who is soon going to be present in his body and blood and soul and divinity in the most holy sacrament of the altar. And he's going to be present in his word as we pray the scriptural rosary. And as John Paul the Great says, to gaze with Mary on Jesus in the mysteries and step right into the mysteries and talk to Jesus and listen to him and receive his love and his mercy so that we can be his jubilee of mercy for the whole world. Brothers and sisters, our ancestors throughout history prayed the rosary with faith and saw mountains moved. They saw enemies reconciled. They saw families reunited. They saw people healed. We're going to stand with them, and we are going to pray with faith today. And to encourage you, we all have stories. Any one of you could stand up and share stories of faith. But I'm going to share one story of faith that's going to encourage you and stir up all of our faith to pray with fire. I was at an abortion clinic recently, and I was praying the rosary, going back and forth in front of the clinic, praying, Hail Mary, Hail Mary. And there were quite a number of late-term women who were in the clinic. And there was a family members and friends of one of the women who was in the clinic waiting outside. And I just sensed the Lord saying to me, go and pray with them. Go and pray with them, and I will act. I didn't know what to do. These were complete strangers. What would they think? How would they react to me? So when I approached the car, they rolled down the window, and I just began to sing. And then I asked them if they would pray with me, and they said yes. And we began to just pray, and I continued to sing, and we prayed, and I continued to sing. And the Lord acted. This beautiful young mother came out of the clinic. She came up to where we were praying and where I was singing. And we were able to offer her the resources that she needed and pray with her and counsel her. And she changed her mind and she left. Isn't that amazing? The power of prayer. the power of praise, the power of the rosary. So that's why we're here today. We just ask the Holy Spirit right now to stir up faith in us. Stir up the fire of the Holy Spirit. Stir up the joy of the Holy Spirit. I will sing a song, Gaze with Mary on Jesus. And I just ask you to close your eyes and picture Jesus gazing right back at you. It's in that place of intimacy with Jesus that miracles are born. That miracles are born. Let's just rest our heads on Mary's shoulder and just let this be a lullaby, as we rest our heads on Mary's shoulder and gaze with Mary on Jesus. Praise you, Jesus.
That shines for you alone. Pray with Mary to Jesus and lead the lost lambs onto his throne. Gaze on Jesus in Mary's womb, Savior of the world. Darkness and gloom. Gaze with Mary on Jesus. See the love in his eyes that shines for you alone. Pray with Mary to Jesus and lead the lost lambs to his throne. Gaze on Jesus, a tiny babe, Savior of the world. Run to him, do not be afraid. Gaze with Mary on Jesus. See him smiling, hear him singing as he gazes on you. Gaze with Mary on Jesus and lead the lost lambs onto his throne. Gaze on Jesus, gazing on you. Shines for you alone. Gaze with Mary on Jesus and lead the lost lambs onto his throne. Gaze on Jesus, alive again, risen from the dead. Hear him singing as he gazes on you. Gaze with Mary on Jesus and lead the lost lambs onto his throne.
brothers and sisters, the kingdom of God is not a matter of talk, but of power. And we are going to see the Lord move in power today. We are going to experience him move in power in our own hearts as he brings to mind people that he wants us to be reconciled with. And he's going to fill our hearts with such joy and such love for these people. He's going to move in power as he heals the sick, as he gives hope to those in despair. He is going to move in power, so just be alert to his love filling your heart, spilling out. And as he moves in power for the intention for which we pray, amen.
Religious liberty. It's not just the freedom to preach the gospel with words, important though that is. It also includes the freedom to engage in apostolic works without being required to do things that undermine the very gospel we proclaim. This is precisely the freedom that the federal government is trying to deny the Little Sisters of the Poor and other groups. Our sisters have wholeheartedly embraced the gospel of Jesus Christ, and they bear witness to it in their mission of caring for the elderly poor. Yet the government is insisting that they cooperate in acts they recognize as gravely wrong. Our sisters are being told that they must help the government give their own employees access to sterilizations, contraceptive drugs and devices, some of which in reality cause abortions, and counseling about so-called reproductive services. If they resist, they will be subject to debilitating fines that would make it impossible for their ministry to continue. Well, the Little Sisters have quite rightly and very bravely resisted. Their case will soon be heard by the Supreme Court. They simply want to continue their ministry to the elderly poor without violating their conscience. They've had to spend much energy defending their cause, and this simply distracts from their wonderful mission. So we're here today to pray for our sisters, that they be allowed to carry out their ministry to the least of Jesus' brothers and sisters in peace. The denial of religious liberty has always been a cause of suffering for Christians. Listen to the words from the closing hymn we'll sing, Faith of Our Fathers. One of the verses says, "Our fathers chained in prisons dark were still in heart and conscience free. How sweet would be their children's fate if they, like them, could die for thee." And then there's the refrain, "Faith of our fathers, holy faith, we will be true to thee till death." Well, we've not yet been required to resist to the point of shedding blood, but we should take heart from the witness of our forebears who have done so. Let's wholeheartedly support the Little Sisters in their mission and in their fidelity to the gospel, to find the strength to resist evil and serve the needy. We need to call upon not just our own strength, but on the Holy Spirit. So Janice is going to lead us in a song to invite the Holy Spirit to be with us during our prayer.
This is a children's song. The Lord says, unless you become like a little child, you cannot enter the kingdom. So I'm going to ask the little children to come forward again. If you could come forward, the children come forward and sing with me and lead everybody. The children wanted to come today to pray with the sisters and to show the sisters and the elderly their support and their solidarity. So this is a children's song. It's Come Holy Spirit, Set Me on Fire. And we're going to ask the children just to come right up front and to help me sing and help all of us to sing and to call upon the Holy Spirit. Come on, don't be shy. Come, right up. Beautiful. Great. Thank you. Now, you've sung this with me before. You can just stay right there. Oh, no, well, yeah. Could come right around me. Sure. Excellent. Right around me. Great. Okay. So we're praying to the Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit, set me on fire. Fill me with fire, the fire of your love. It's right there in your programs. We ask the Lord to give us, as Catherine Doherty would say, Lord, give us the heart of a child and the awesome courage to live it out. Come, Holy Spirit, come, Holy Spirit, set me on fire.
Set me on fire.
Fill me with fire.
Fill me with fire.
The fire of your love.
The fire of your love.
Holy Spirit,
come, Holy Spirit,
set me on fire.
Set me on fire.
Fill me with fire.
Fill me with fire.
Of your joy,
the fire of your joy.
Come, Holy Spirit,
come, Holy Spirit,
set me on fire,
set me on fire.
Fill me with fire,
fill me with fire.
The fire of faith,
the fire of faith.
Amen. Come, Holy Spirit. Thank you, children.
Salutaris hostia, quae celi pandis hostium, vera praemunt hostilia, tarobur fer
of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead.
I believe in
the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. For an increase in faith, hope, and charity. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The joyful mysteries of the Rosary, the first joyful mystery, the Annunciation of the Lord. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And he came to her and said, Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you. But she was greatly troubled at the saying and considered in her mind what sort of greeting this might be. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And the angel said to her, Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Amen.
And Mary said to the angel, How shall this be, since I have no husband? Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word." Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Sing aloud, O daughter of Zion. Rejoice and exult with all your heart. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. The Lord your God will rejoice over you with gladness. He will renew you in his love. He will exult over you with loud singing, as on a day of festival. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. He delivered them from their distress. He sent forth his word and healed them and delivered them from destruction. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those who most need thy mercy. The second joyful mystery, the visitation. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. The Lord gives the barren woman a home, making her the joyous mother of children. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. The angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zechariah. For your prayer is heard, and your wife, Elizabeth, will bear you a son, and you shall call his name John." Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. For you formed my inward parts. You knitted me together in my mother's womb. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. In those days, Mary arose and went with haste into the hill country to a city of Judah, and she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And when Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary, the babe leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. She exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus." And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her from the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, amen.
His mercy is on those who fear him, from generation to generation. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Through the tender mercy of our God, the day shall dawn upon us from on high to give light to those who sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, to guide our feet into the way of peace. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of death.
Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins. Save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those. Joyful mystery, the Nativity of the Lord. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and
Joseph went up from Galilee to Bethlehem to be enrolled with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no place for him in the inn. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. There were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with fear. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And the angel said to them, be not afraid, for behold, I bring you good news of a great joy, which will come to all the people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And when they saw it, they made known the saying which had been told them concerning this child. And all who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. But Mary kept all these things, pondering them in her heart. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. For while gentle silence enveloped all things, and night in its swift course was now half gone, your all-powerful word leaped from heaven, from the royal throne, into the midst of the land that was doomed. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. The people who sat in darkness have seen a great light, and for those who sat in the region and shadow of death, light has dawned. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. But you, O Bethlehem Ephrathah, who are too little to be among the clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to be ruler in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. God sent forth his Son, born of woman, so that we might receive adoption as sons. And because you are sons, God has sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, Save us from the fires of hell. Lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. Fourth joyful mystery, the presentation of the Lord. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. When the time came for their purification, according to the law of Moses, they brought him up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Now, there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he should not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Inspired by the Spirit, he came into the temple. And when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him according to the custom of the law, he took him up in his arms and blessed God. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, and for glory to your people Israel. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Simeon blessed them and said to Mary his mother, behold, this child is set for the fall and rising of many in Israel. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And a sword will pierce through your own soul also, that thoughts out of many hearts may be revealed. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
It is too light a thing that you should be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the preserved of Israel. I will give you as a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the end of the earth. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up, O ancient doors, that the King of glory may come in. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy. The fifth joyful mystery, the finding of the child Jesus in the temple. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Now, his parents went to Jerusalem every year at the feast of the Passover, and when he was 12 years old, they went up according to custom. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. When the feast was ended, as they were returning, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem. His parents did not know it. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were amazed at his understanding and his answers. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. When they saw him, they were astonished, and his mother said to him, "Son, why have you treated us so? Behold, your father and I have been looking for you anxiously." Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. He said to them, "How is it that you sought me? Did you not know that I must be in my Father's house?" Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And they did not understand the saying which he spoke to them. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. He went down with them and came to Nazareth and was obedient to them. And his mother kept all these things in her heart. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. One thing have I asked of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Come, let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach us his ways, and that we may walk in his paths. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. And the temple was filled with joy and gladness now that the Almighty Lord had appeared. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners,
now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins. Save us from the fires of hell.
Lead all souls to heaven, especially those who most need thy mercy.
Ave, ave, ave Maria. Ave, ave Maria.
Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the other evil spirits who roam through the world seeking the ruin of souls. Sacred Heart of Jesus, Sacred Heart of Jesus, Sacred Heart of Jesus, Immaculate Heart of Mary, all you angels and saints, pray for us now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Sanctum ergo sacramentum veneremur cernui et anticum documentum nova cera ritui restet fides supplementum sensum
You gave them bread from heaven. Let us pray. O God, who in this wondrous sacrament have blessed us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we beseech you, so to venerate the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may perceive within us the effects of your redemption, who lives and reigns world without end. Amen. Blessed be God. Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be the name of
Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Consoler.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary, most holy.
Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be her glorious Assumption.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
Please be seated. Brothers and sisters, we are in a spiritual battle. Our battle is not against flesh and blood, but against the principalities and powers of darkness. And the Lord has given us everything we need for victory. And this is the Jubilee year of mercy, brothers and sisters. The Lord wants to pour out his mercy on us, and in us and through us in abundance, in ways that we can see, in ways that we can experience. So I'm going to sing a song called Jubilee of Mercy, and the refrain is, he is with us, and the refrain is calling us to be his Jubilee of Mercy for the world, calling us to be your Jubilee of Mercy for the world. So please join in and listen to the words. Darkness flees at the sound of your glorious name, Jesus. Trampling death by death, you rose from the grave, Jesus. And you are calling us to be your Jubilee of Mercy for the whole world. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Lord Jesus. Come, Lord Jesus.
I bow down to the ground at the sound of your name, Jesus. Every knee shall bow at the sound of your name. You are with us, calling us to be your Jubilee of Mercy for the whole world. All creation came into being through you, Jesus. Everything new, you are with us, calling us to be your Jubilee of Mercy for the whole world. Trampling death
Brothers and sisters, we sense the presence of the Lord very powerfully in our midst. And every one of you have come today to support the sisters and the elderly whom they serve. The Lord has gifts for you to take home. He wants to give them to you. He wants to speak to each one of our hearts, I sense right now, that we would take a moment of silence and just listen to what Jesus is speaking to each one of us uniquely, unrepeatably, right now. The mercy that he wants to pour into that area in our life that is most in need of his mercy. And just to receive his mercy in that place of need. Hear the word that he is speaking to you personally. And Lord, as we go forth from here, we ask you to give us the grace to remember to continue praying for the sisters and their cause, especially this week. And Lord, we ask you to show us how you are calling each one of us specifically to be your mercy for the world during this Jubilee Year of Mercy. I'd now like to ask Sister Constance to come up and speak. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Janice. We Little Sisters of the Poor would just like to thank, first of all, Janice Clark and Father Peter Ryan and our own Monsignor Joseph Ranieri for leading us in prayer this afternoon. We'd like to thank a very special thank you to the Apostolic Nuncio, Archbishop Vigano, who joined us this afternoon. You know, the Archbishop Nuncio is the Holy Father's representative in our country. And so by his being here with us today, he has brought Pope Francis among us as well, just as the day when the Pope visited us right here in this chapel last year when he was in the United States. So that brings back very special memories. And he visited us here, the sisters here, in order to encourage us and instill courage in us for this cause of religious liberty. And so we thank you very especially, Archbishop Vigano, for being with us today. We also want to thank the rest of you for being with us, those of you who are here in the chapel with us, and anybody who has joined us through Shalom World TV. So we thank you very, very much for the support of your prayers. You know, some of the journalists who have interviewed us have asked me what we'll do if, you know, we don't prevail in this case. And frankly, we little sisters don't have an answer. We have not visited that possibility because we're trusting fully in God, just as our foundress always did. She had remarkable confidence in divine providence. And so we are doing the same thing. We're placing our trust in God that he won't abandon us in this moment of need. And so your prayers, the support of your prayers, means so much to us. I would also like to thank in advance all those who will be helping us and participating in our day on Wednesday. This coming Wednesday, the 23rd, is the day of the oral argument before the Supreme Court. And there are many people who will be supporting us that day. I'd like to thank especially the women of Women Speak for Themselves, a group of very pro-life women that has formed in the last couple of years. And they will be sponsoring a rally outside the Supreme Court that morning. I think the more the merrier. Everybody is welcome to join us. We have the Little Sisters will be there along with some of the sisters who are here today and about 100 other sisters who are coming from various spots around the United States to help support us and pray with us and for us that day. There will be college students there, and there's room for everybody outside the Supreme Court, and we want to show a very united front for life. So I thank ahead of time the women of Women Speak for Themselves who are organizing this event. They will also be spreading out across the country to offer a day of service in our homes for the elderly across the United States, just to give a peaceful, quiet witness of the value of human life and the dignity and value of the elderly. And so we won't be having any of them here in DC because the local women will be down at the Supreme Court with us, but they will be in many of our homes across the country. And I know our sisters are looking forward to that as well. So I thank the women of women who speak for them, women speak for themselves. So with that, I would just like to invite all of you who are with us in person to join us in our cafe for refreshments after the holy hour. Our residents and our volunteers and associates who are here with us can show you the way. I'd like to include everyone who's watching, but you know that's not possible. But we will keep you also in our very grateful prayers as we enter into the Holy Triduum next week. You know, we have the case on Wednesday, and then we'll be entering into the prayer and silence of Holy Thursday, Good Friday, and then Easter. So again, thank you very much, and God bless you all.
I'd also like to express my incredible gratitude to Shalom World and the sacrifices that they've made to be here today. And they're going to be broadcasting this 9 p.m. tomorrow evening. So if you want to recommend it to your friends so that they can join us in prayer again tomorrow evening, it's shalomworld.org. It will be available again broadcast. Thank you. So we'll now stand for our closing hymn, Faith of Our Fathers, and let's sing out particularly boisterously the verse that Father quoted. And there'll be refreshments afterwards for anybody who would like to just mingle with the sisters or the elderly. And also, Father Peter would be here until 3:30 for anybody who would just like a personal prayer. If you'd like to come forward for a personal prayer, he'd love to pray with you. So let's sing together, Faith of Our Fathers.
And I've been working on religious freedom, specifically the HH mandate case, which is what the Little Sisters are contesting, for almost 5 years now. It is very surprising that the federal government has brought us to this day when the Little Sisters next week are facing an oral argument before the Supreme Court about maintaining their religious freedom. We've gathered here today at a Little Sisters house in Washington, D.C. in order to show solidarity with the Little Sisters. And it's the best possible way because people have come in prayer to support the Little Sisters, not just because they love the Little Sisters, which they do, and they love the work they do, but also because they are supporting them really in a struggle for religious freedom. The federal government is really bent on an ideology that says that contraception and abortion are the heart of women's freedom. And they just don't understand the Catholic Christian ethic. In fact, it's the same ethic that leaves the Little Sisters to take care of the bodies and souls of the elderly that they do. An ethic that says the human person, the human body, has weight. And so the Little Sisters have refused to buckle under to the federal pressure. So next week, we're going to have this oral argument next Wednesday before the Supreme Court. There's going to be a gathering at the court, and we're hoping that people will come by the hundreds, especially young women, because the federal government says that it's supporting young women and the sisters are not. So we are hoping to have many women on the steps of the U.S. Supreme Court to support the Little Sisters. If we win this case, it will be a vindication of religious freedom, as I am sure our founding fathers and mothers intended. If, in the Lord's own judgment, that this case should not be won, if we should lose, it's going to be a very dramatic loss for religious freedom. If they can force us to stand down while the government promotes contraception and abortion through religious institutions, what's next? I think it's probably going to be assisted suicide. In fact, already a group supporting assisted suicide is going to be on the steps of the Supreme Court next week, opposing the Little Sisters, so that Catholic health care for the elderly and the sick would be forced to cooperate with assisted suicide. There's a lot at stake, and that's what people came here today to pray about. And it's frankly what we need, the prayer and solidarity of people all over the United States to pray with us on this, because this case, it's important in its own right, but it's also important for religious freedom overall.